Arrested Abu Sayyaf leader Andul Jihad Idang Susukan is now at the Philippine National Police headquarters in Camp Crame, Quezon City. He arrived from Davao early Saturday morning. For more on the impact of Susukan's arrest, joining us live is Philippine Armed Forces spokesperson, Major General Edgard Arevalo. Good morning, sir.
Good morning, Vivian, and all our televiewers. Good morning.
Yes, sir. Abu Sayyaf leader Idang Susukan was transported to Camp Crame from Davao City today. How will the government proceed with his case from here on?
Well, moving forward, investigations are going to be undertaken. He has to go custodial debriefing. Necessary information has to be drawn from him, especially on with regard to the movement of their group. And of course, we are awaiting for the final decision of the court as to where eventually Idang Susukan will be detained.
Okay. Can you let us in on the details of how Susukan ended up being, quote-unquote, handed over by the Moro Islamic or Moro National Liberation Front founding chairman Nur Misauri to the Philippine National Police?
Well, practically, we don't have much information about that, Vivian. As a matter of fact, I think investigation has to be underway for the determination of the information as regards those particular details. What we know for now was that there were reports that Idang Susukan was with Chairman Nur Misauri, and we validated that information, and upon knowing that, communication was had between the Commanding General of Eastern Mindanao Command, Lieutenant General Jose Faustino Jr., to speak to the chairman to hand over or turn over the custody of Idang Susukan to the military and to the PNP. Hence, what came after is the actual turnover of Misauri of Susukan to the composite team of the military and the police that evening in the residence of the chairman of the MNLF.
Mm-hmm. Major General Arevalo, I understand that Susukan is also wanted in Malaysia. Will he also face his cases there?
Well, that's correct. We are going to leave that to the courts, but definitely he's involved in many cross-border kidnapping for ransom. Here at home, he faces at least 34 cases of kidnapping with ransom, kidnapping with serious illegal detention, murder, frustrated murder, and many other cases.
Mm-hmm. And how crucial is the arrest of Susukan in the government's efforts against the Abu Sayyaf group?
Well, very crucial, Vivian, because definitely Idang Susukan falls under the category of a sub-leader of the Abu Sayyaf group. He is a key personality to the Abu Sayyaf group. As a matter of fact, his involvement in 34 cases, meaning the 34 warrants of arrest issued against him, indicates how notorious he is and how he is into the heart and the core of the operations of the Abu Sayyaf. That said, his arrest is a big blow on the organization of the Abu Sayyaf in their operations. And with that, we expect that the group or the followers of Idang Susukan will retaliate against the armed forces. In 2003, one of the siblings, Mujib, was neutralized in a combat operations against the armed forces of the Philippines. Way back in 2009, Al Mujahid Susukan, a sibling, was also arrested on that year. And on 8 p.m. in August 13, Idang Susukan was also arrested by the composite team of the AFP and the PNP. So three Susukan siblings have already been either neutralized or arrested. And at each time, there were retaliatory acts on the part of the Abu Sayyaf. But be that as it may, Vivian, we assure our people that your armed forces is ready. We are prepared to repel and to frustrate any and all attempts of this group to sow panic, to sow disorder, and to sow terrorist act. And as a matter of fact, General Gapay, our AFP Chief of Staff, has already directed our frontline commanders to institute all necessary measures, including intelligence efforts and coordinating with the locals, residents and local government unit officers to ensure that there will be a free flow of communication and information. As a matter of fact, these arrests and the neutralization of one of the siblings, Mujib, has all been realized with the good cooperation of the locality.
You did mention the possibility of retaliation and that the AFP is ready in case they retaliate. But how exactly does the AFP plan to intensify its operations? You mentioned information sharing, but will AFP also put more people in areas where this retaliation could possibly happen?
We're going to place more personnel in strategic areas. As I said, this information coming from the people is going to be vital in pinpointing these areas. We are going to coordinate, as we always do, with our counterparts with the Philippine National Police to make sure that all these government security forces plus the force multiplier are able to assist us in ensuring for the safety of our fellow Filipinos in the province of Sulu, Basilan, Tawi-Tawi, and Sambuanga Peninsula.
So on these areas, Sulu, Basilan, Tawi-Tawi, these are the areas where people should be on the alert against possible retaliation from the ASG, or are there other areas that should be on the heads up?
Well, these are the areas where there are known presence of the members of the Abu Sayyaf. But as we know, and what that is also something that we are trying to keep at bay, is to ensure that there will be no movement by this terrorist Abu Sayyaf group in other areas of the Philippines and other key cities. But as we have seen in the past, there have been reports of their presence, but we were successful thus far in ensuring that we will be able to contain them in the province of Sulu, where they are concentrated. This is the reason, Vivian, why amidst the COVID-19 pandemic, your Armed Forces of the Philippines continues and continue to operate until this time to ensure that we are after these terrorists, and they will not be able to slip from Sulu and perform a possible terrorist act in other areas.
How close are we, sir, from completely dismantling the Abu Sayyaf group? Does AFP have a timeline?
It's very difficult for us to put a definite period, but the target is within the presidency of our present Commander-in-Chief, President Duterte. The situation in Sulu is very complicated. The situation is complex, and there are a lot of other considerations and variables that the Armed Forces of the Philippines is taking into account. But by and large, we can say that we are at it. We are at the right track. The number of surrenderers, the number of Abu Sayyaf members who have been neutralized, and those who have expressed their intention to return to the folds of the law are indicative of the success that so far we have been reaping through the leadership of the past chiefs of staff and now Lieutenant General Gilbert Gabay.
Because, sir, in the past, there were statements from the Armed Forces Western Mindanao Command that the Abu Sayyaf could be eliminated by March 31st. What got in the way of achieving that goal, po?
Well, Vivian, these are timelines. In planning, we always have the so-called period within which we would like to get a target accomplished. But as we can see, we have to make necessary adjustments in this timeline or in this target period because of other intervening variables and circumstances which are beyond our control. But we are very positive. We are optimistic that we'll be able to get through all the bottom of this. And remember, the solution to the problem of terrorism is not solely vested on the Armed Forces of the Philippines. There are other matters that needed to be taken into account, and there are other partners that you should join the fight, and that is why there is good governance as the present strategy of the government for us to be able to holistically, as a one nation and various other agencies, work together towards the solution of the problem of the terrorists in Abu Sayyaf in Sulu, and even the communist terrorist group.
Well, we hope that the AFP will achieve its goal of eliminating the ASG before President Duterte steps down. Thank you so much for your time, Major General Edgard Arevalo, the spokesperson of the Philippine Armed Forces.
Good morning, Vivian. Thank you very much.